I'm John Haller. I'm running for Congress in the 14th U.S. Congressional District. I'm a die maker by trade. I grew up in the automotive industry, and we need to bring manufacturing jobs back to Southeast Michigan. If we don't realize that, we're kidding ourselves. We can't reinvent the 14th District. We need blue-collar jobs. I'm the guy that has been in manufacturing his whole life. We need John Haller for Congress. Thank you. The main reason I'm running for Congress is because these elected officials are not overseeing every dollar spent. These stooges need to be sent home. They are passing laws, reinventing the wheel every 2 years. We have enough regulations, enough laws on the books that have to be looked at and eliminated. Let's stop joking. Let's stop kidding ourselves. These guys are career politicians and it needs to end. I only want to go there for 2 terms. Do what I say I'm going to do and go home. That's what has to happen. These elected officials need to understand that they need to live and work in the environment that they're creating. And that's why you need to vote for John Haller. Thank you.
Hey, how are you? That's right, good to meet you.
It has gone one way in the past doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to go the same way in the future, and here's why. Voters are waking up at every level. They're waking up to failed ideals, failed policies, and failed leadership. So I think Michigan is going to be a toss-up.
I think so too.
Yep.
Latest statistics today were Romney 45, Obama 44 in Michigan.
And that means it's a dead heat. And that also means that a lot of independents have not made up their mind yet, which is a good thing. Which means that if Romney continues to sharpen his message, and President Obama continues to insult the business community, insult the producers, insult people in general, I think that we're going to see that number move up.
How do you feel that he will deal with the corporate tax, which is the second highest in the world, and other regulations that are basically whipping corporations right out of the country and making it so hard for individuals to start businesses? And also the credit, I believe Obama had taken away from small and medium-sized businesses and shut that down as well. How do you think Mr. Romney might do with those two problems?
He's already stated that, first of all of the Obama-era regulations, he's going to ask Congress to roll them back. If they were done at the regulatory level, he can roll them back as president. He also has announced that he is going to slash corporate rates, personal rates, and the capital gains rate. Now, obviously, he has to get the United States Congress to send him that legislation, but he's already stated that. One thing that Governor Romney understands, that President Obama doesn't understand, you don't raise revenue by raising taxes. You don't boost the economy by insulting the business community. That's what drives this economy. Governor Romney understands that. And all of these distractions about Bain Capital and all of these distractions about he should release 2 more years of his tax return. Who cares? The American people, number one, they care about 2 things, top and foremost. Number one, a growing, robust economy. And it's not happening. And I firmly believe, or I wouldn't be out here talking on Governor Romney's behalf, he knows what to do in order to make that happen. His ideas may not be as bold as some others, but they are in the right direction. The second thing that the American people understand, national security. They understand that this administration has gutted our military. And I know that Governor Romney will reverse that trend.
How about the fact that under the present regime, we've lost a lot of credibility with a lot of our allies. They've been sort of slapped in the face, in a sense, beginning with Great Britain all the way through throughout the world. How do you think Mr. Romney will deal with that? And is there time to smooth that over? Is it too late with some of our allies?
It's not too late to smooth it over with our allies, because if anyone understands how to create consistent relationships with our allies, it's someone who turned the Olympics around. How do you turn around the Olympics if you don't know how to work with an international community? And so he will use those skills in order to reverse some of the damage that has been caused by this administration.
How do you feel about the young man next to you?
This young man next to me, Brad Hantler, I'm going to put it this way. If I were his age, I wouldn't do it. That's why it is admirable that he's doing what he's doing, because I ask him about that. A lot of people forget that a lot of the voters that are going to determine the future of this country are his age. So why shouldn't somebody his age be a representative to determine the future of the state of Michigan and, in a large sense, the future of this country? So people who want to talk about, well, he's not old enough, look, we're in the mess that we're in because of a lot of dumb old leaders. So we're in the mess that we're in as a nation because of a lot of dumb old leaders who've been around too long. I'm glad to see somebody willing to step up, and I think that is quite admirable.
Herman, can you talk about coming here to Michigan for a state house race? It seems like 9 months ago, you know, you were chasing the presidency, and now you're here at a state house race. Can you comment on getting down to the local community, as it appears that you're doing to me?
All politics, I see this economy, I see this nation as three tiers. You got the national economy, you got the state economy, and you got the local economy. If you don't get the national economy right, and then the state responds, then it's not going to help the local economy. The kitchen table economy is what the American people are looking for some relief. And their kitchen table economy is not going to get better unless the national economy gets better and the state economy gets better. Brad understands that. One of the ideas that impresses me the most about Brad Hantler is his idea that the Michigan legislature is a full-time legislature, which means that they stay in session too long, and the more time you give politicians to pass laws, the more time they have to screw up the state. Quote me on that. Look at most of the most successful states in the country. They don't have full-time legislatures. I'm not mad at y'all, I'm just passionate about this, okay? They don't. You don't need a full-time legislature. I'll go one step further. We don't need a Congress that's in session year-round, except for a few vacations. That's part of the problem. As long as they're in session, they think they've got to pass stuff. I have a novel idea. Let's unpass stuff. We got too much stuff on the table. So that is one big idea that I totally support. And that's the benefit of having someone as young as he is who are looking at it from a fresh point of view.
Two more questions. I'd like to ask you about one question, and then I want to ask you a question. Concerning our relationship with our adversaries, it was reported that Mr. Obama had made a little gesture to Putin, hey, just wait until after the election and I'll give you what you want, basically to disarm the country. How do you think Mr. Romney will deal with something like that?
Mr. Romney would not try and cut backdoor deals and side deals with other countries who are our enemies. There are several things that you can say about Governor Romney that the mainstream media is not focusing on. Governor Romney will not compromise the integrity of the United States of America. He will not compromise our national security. Governor Romney, because of his values were demonstrated throughout his business career and his political career. Look at his values. He would not do things like that. And so that, I think, would go a long way to send a very strong signal to our adversaries. Our adversaries around the world understand one, they understand two things. And America has been a leader in the world because of these two things. And one of them was not compromised, and that is our military might and the strength of our economy. That's what they respect. not a leader who's going to kowtow or apologize.
Last question. Mr. Hantler, I'd like to ask you, one of the greatest strangleholds on the Michigan economy has been the massive union organizations. What would you propose to sort of unshackle a Michigan from that problem?
The problem that we face is that the pensions that they face right now. I want to propose moving all public pensions over to 401ks. The private sector needs to be the same as the public sector. They can't just have these ridiculous pensions that you never see in the private sector. And so why are they getting it when the private sector doesn't? The country can't survive when the public sector is getting paid more than the private sector. There's no reason to go private, no reason to be an entrepreneur.
And if I might add, he's perfectly correct. I have served on the boards of many corporations for many years before I ran for president. The private sector has been in 401 type plans for a long time. The employees take ownership in that rather than expecting these outrageous benefits that, quite frankly, companies can't afford and the state can't afford. States are dying because of promises made in the past. Now, I don't know what Michigan is ultimately going to do, but the direction that he's talking about is the only direction that's going to allow the state to survive long-term from the weight of those plans.
Any final words that you want to give to the American people?
Any final words I would like to give to the American people? I love these kind of questions. Here's what I would like to say to the American people. Wake up, America. America is on a dangerous path because of the leadership in Washington, D.C. It's not too late for us to change it, but we have to do it now. It's not about color. It's not about party. It's about the survival of the United States of America. And to those people that only look at the rhetoric and the hype, you're not only doing a disservice to the founding fathers, you're doing a disservice to your children and your grandchildren. In other words, in this election, don't be stupid.
I'm Bradley's grandmother, and I'm very proud of him.
I'm Bradley's grandmother, and I'm very proud of him, and I know he's going to win, and the whole world is looking at him.
Hi, I'm Don Valera, coming from the United States Congress. I'm down here in West Bloomfield. I'm supporting Brad Hantler. I was here to see Herman Cain, Mr. 999. I'm running in the new ninth. We were out yesterday at a protest in front of Sandra Levin's office because we were supporting to audit the Fed. Bill 459 did pass today in Congress, but let's see what Harry Reid will do with it. Most likely he's just going to bury it. Because, you know, everyone deserves to know where 7 cents of their dollars goes. This isn't about Republicans and Democrats when it comes to our money. This is about transparency. But thank you so much for your time, and go out and vote for Don Valera in 2012. Thank you so much.
Brad's special guest, I don't think I need to introduce, is one-time presidential candidate Herman Cain. Herman's here for one special reason, and he'll talk about why he's here. But before we get into the introduction of our host, Brad Hantler, tonight, and why we're all here, I'd like to introduce a couple of special people that are in the audience. Let's start off with the non-elected special people. There's quite a bit of media around the room, from NBC, from Detroit News, but one of our favorite brand new radio voice personalities from Conservative Talk Radio 1270 WXYT, Doc Thompson, is in the back of the room. Doc's here with his producer, as well as his wife from Dayton, Ohio. Doc happened to move into this state representative. So it's great to have Doc Thompson here from 1270 XYT. Also, we have a couple candidates and elected officials. We have the Chief Justice of the Michigan Supreme Court, Justice Young, here tonight. Hello, Supreme Court. Court Justice Brian Zara. Brian. And Brian is on the ballot this November as well. We also have our Oakland County Clerk, Bill Bullard. And a whole host of candidates, believe it or not. We do have a list of candidates here. We have two congressional candidates, one from the 9th Congressional District, Don Valerik. One from the 14th Congressional District, which I believe this may or may not be, depending on redistricting. I'm still trying to figure out where the lines are exactly. But John Holler from the 14th
Congressional
District. And did I miss any other candidates? I missed who? Ron Edwards. Ron Edwards from the Ron Edwards Notebook. I always ask for a list of people to introduce because you know you're going to upset somebody. I have Farmington Hills' very own lonely conservative school board member, Dr. Khan. We're all here. We're all here to support Brad Hantler for state representative. Brad Hantler is running in the 39th Congressional District. Many of you know it encompasses the areas of Wixom, Commerce, Wolverine Township, and this part of West Bloomfield. So Brad is working really hard, and some people around the district and some people outside the district, actually, because inside the district, Brad is doing exceptionally well. But outside the district, they're saying, well, isn't he awfully young to run for state representative? And it is my pleasure to stand here with Brad, to endorse Brad and support Brad, because Brad is only a year and a half younger than what I was when I was elected state rep. So I truly believe that we do need that fresh blood and people with ideas. And Herman Cain will share some words on that as well. But without any further ado, it's my pleasure to support the number one candidate in the 39th State House seat, Brad Hantler.
First off, I just want to say thank you for everyone coming out here tonight. And a special thank you to the host committee, Karen Fayette, Kathy DeLorenzo, our Attorney General Mike Cox, Shelley Taub, Joe Green, Roger Redzikowski, and many others that have helped out tremendously with our campaign so far. I mean, the fact is, the very beginning, almost a year ago, we did a poll to see where I was. I was in dead last. And then I was 21, no one knew my name. But every day since then, we've been out there knocking on doors 7 days a week, 8 hours a day. And because of that and everyone that's helping me out, we're currently in first place. We're up by 5 points. Yeah, the fact is, I'm not going Republican drama. There's five others in this race. But the issue is, all the other Republicans, all they're doing is talk about Republican rhetoric and slogans. And that's something I refuse to do. I'm proposing real, bold ideas to turn Michigan around. The first one, we need to repeal the personal property tax.
Right.
Is we need to make Michigan move from a full-time to a part-time legislature. Because we're one of four states in the whole country that's still full-time. They're paying about $80,000 a year, when every other state pays about $25,000 to $30,000. So when they're taxing your pensions, they're cutting the roads, they're cutting education, why are they making three times more than every other state legislature? Makes no sense. The third idea is we have to make public sector employees. We need to make their pensions in line with the private sector. We need to move them to 401k. The fact is, right now, it's just unsustainable. We just can't keep on doing it. It's not going to work out. And so what I tell you is that, you know, I'm here, I'm running, and I'll be honest, you know, being 21, being a recent college grad, you know, many people don't like Republicans in college. It's not something that people would like. But I've been working here, putting myself on the line. I got 30 or 40 people my age that are helping me walk every day. And any support I can get from you guys would be unbelievable. I'm currently about to introduce Mr. Cain very shortly, but before I let the mic go, on your way out here tonight. Now, we have yard signs, we have ways you can help the campaign, we have literature, tell your neighbors, tell anyone you know, because between first and second place, it's going to be less than 500 votes. So, I mean, really, I need your help, and thank you very much for coming. And without any further ado, I'd like to introduce the former presidential candidate, Mr. Herman Cain.
Thank you very much. I'm delighted to be here. I'm delighted that Brad invited me, that his family invited me. And as usual, the Michigan hospitality has been outstanding. This afternoon, after we had done two events today, we did one this morning in Grand Rapids. We did another event with some business leaders at lunch in the area. And then Steve Hantler, Brad's dad, was nice enough to take us to his home to relax for a couple of hours. Well, I did just that. Steve invited me to go downstairs in the lower level of his very nice home over on Green Lake and gave me a little quiet time. I had to make some phone calls. I had to call some TV producers and do a few other things. And he said, take your time. If you want to take a power nap, go right ahead. So I'm sitting here on this very comfortable sofa with my feet up. And I took a power nap. He asked me to take a power nap. I've been going all day. And then a strange thing happened. Remember, I travel a lot. This was my third event of the day. So I'm sitting here with my head back, taking a power nap, so I'm sweet. The phone rings. It was his house phone. I answered it. I thought I was at home. If I'm at home and the phone rings and you wake up, you answer the phone. So I pick up the phone. This is a true story, folks. I can't make this stuff up. Hello? I really forgot that I was at Steve Howe. I said, hello? Well, Mr. Cain, we want to thank you. Now, Mr. Hantler, we want to thank you for the money you contributed to Tea Party Patriots last year, and we're calling to find out whether or not you will contribute that same level again this year to Tea Party Patriots. I said, yes. And Mr. Hantler, could we verify your address and your telephone number so they read off the address? Yes. Read off the telephone number? Yes. I had no damn idea what I was saying yes to. But I spent some more of Steve Hantler's money and I didn't even know it because I was half asleep. I felt that much at home. And that's the way I feel here in Michigan. I feel at home because of the hospitality here in Michigan. A few things that are consistent all over this country. The only people that don't get it are in Washington, D.C. The people that get it are out here, and they're people like you. And I've had several interviews who've asked me several questions, which I will share with my answer to these several questions. First of all, you know, media people, not all, some of them, are skeptical. So, the first thing they wanted to know, well, how do you know Brad Hantler? The answer, I know Brad through his family. And I know his family, and I know their values. You don't evaluate people based upon labels. You basically make an assessment of people based upon their values. Secondly, like Brad indicated, his ideas are bold ideas. The American people are ready for bold ideas. Not the same old, same old, same old. That was another thing that attracted me to Brad. And then when I was doing a radio interview a couple of days ago, the radio host said, but he's only 21. How can a 21-year-old know what to do without life experiences? I said, he might be 21 years old, but common sense trumps life experiences. Common sense says you don't need a full-time, fully paid state legislature, because the longer that they are in session, the more time they have to screw things up. Most of the states that are the strongest in this nation, they don't have full-time, full-paid legislators. So that is a bold solution that he's putting on the table. He's not going to be able to do it by himself. He's going to need your help. He's going to need your help to get him there, and then once he gets there, he's going to need your help to put the pressure on the legislature to make it happen. Bold ideas. Now, here's another little statistic that most people don't even know. In the last presidential election, nearly 15% of the voters were 30 years of age or younger. Why shouldn't the younger part of our voting electorate have somebody to represent them? What's wrong with that? Nothing. The old people have demonstrated that they know how to screw it up and screw it up grossly. So why not have someone who will look at problems from a different perspective and bring a different view? So those are the reasons that I'm enthusiastic about supporting Brad Hantler. Because I also happen to believe that as we look at this nation, we've got problems at the national level. We got problems at the state level. And we got problems at the local level. When we begin to fix the problems at the national level, if we don't have the right leadership at the local level, guess what? It won't make a difference. Our biggest domestic challenge is this economy. So goes the national economy, so goes the state economy, so goes the kitchen table economy. That's why you got to have the kind of leadership at the local level in order to make it happen. Now, I'm not mad at y'all, I just get passionate about this stuff, okay? My wife tells me sometimes, you are beginning to sound like an angry black man. I said, sweetheart, I just get passionate about this. Because like you, I believe in the United States of America. We're still the greatest country in the world. Like you, I believe we can take it back. The American dream is under attack. But I happen to believe we can take it back. That's why I'm doing what I do. I'm not supporting many state candidates. I'm supporting a few congressional candidates. Because we've got to not only have the right person in the White House, we've got to have the right people in the state houses as well. And that's what this is about. That's what this is about. And so even though the American dream is under attack, I am confident that we can take it back. We got to take it back at all levels. There's just as much corruption and dirt at the local level as there is at the federal level. And that's why we need people like Brad. And I told him earlier today, I said, Brad, I admire you. Many young people at 21 years of age, just graduating from college, are trying to go around the world to find themselves. Brad wants to help save his community. That's admirable. That is admirable. And when I made the decision to run for president of the United States, yes, I had a temporary moment of insanity in order to make that decision, because there was no logical reason that I should have done that. Just like there's no logical reason that Brad shouldn't do what he's doing, other than you love your country more, that you are patriotic about what we need to do in order to turn this country around. And even though my campaign was derailed because of character assassination, and even though I am not still pursuing the position of president, I am still on a personal mission, and that is to defeat Barack Obama in November. That's my mission. Last mission is to change Michigan. You all have graduates leaving here at an absolutely fast rate. You got to change the dynamics. You got to change the landscape. You got to give young people a reason to stay in the state of Michigan, just like we got to give people a reason to stay in this, all of the various states. And we've got to give business people a reason to keep on busting their ass and build businesses, because it ain't about the government. I know that it is not politically correct to say the A word, but I would like to remind people that I ain't running for nothing, so I don't give a fuck. I didn't go to political correctness school. If I had, I would have flunked. For the president to say, those people that built those businesses, they didn't do that. Tell that to my dad, who walked off of a farm at the age of 18 from Tennessee, and the only thing he had on his back were the clothes on his back. Tell my dad, who's now deceased, who achieved his American dream by at one time using the only equity that he had, sweat equity. My dad didn't want to hear about paved roads and bridges. When he walked off of that farm, the roads weren't even paved. It was his sweat equity that allowed him to achieve his American dream. That's what this is about. Brad is dreaming of a better America, because he's taking the time to figure out just how messed up it is at all levels. The thing that inspires me as I travel around the country is that there are so many patriots who really want this nation to get back on track. I was in Reno, Nevada yesterday, and I gave a speech yesterday in Reno, Nevada at a rally. They didn't think we could get 250 people to come out to the rally. We did. We got 500 people to come out to the rally. They care about this nation just like you. And I happen to believe that it is because of the movement and the decisions and the passion that's in this room that's going to allow us not only help get Michigan on the right track, it's going to help get this nation on the right track. Three simple things that I challenge you to do for Brad, for Michigan, and for this country. Stay informed. Stupid people are ruining America. We gotta know the facts and stay informed. Stay involved. You can't just sit home and throw your house shoes at the TV set because you don't like what you hear. You can't just complain. Stay involved at any level, at all levels. Everybody can do something. Figure out what that is and do it. We may not get another chance to take this nation back, so don't sit back and think it's going to happen without our help. So stay informed, stay involved, and stay inspired. Don was inspired to run for Congress in one of my favorite congressional districts, the 9th District of Michigan. The new 9th District. We've got about 4 or 5 people running for Congress that are from the 9th District in their respective states. And one of the things that a lot of people don't really appreciate, if you never run for office, is the sacrifice that's made. So to all of the people that currently hold office, and all of the people that are running for office, I commend you, because I know what it's like. I know what it's like for a candidate. And when people become Supreme Court justices, or congressmen, or senators, or state legislators, and you call them the honorable, they deserve that title of honorable because they had to give up a lot in order to serve their communities. That's why they deserve that designation as honorable. So we can do this in all levels, but we got to stay informed, involved, and lastly, we got to stay inspired. You see, the liberals want you to believe that we can't do this. The liberals want you to believe that a 21-year-old young whippersnapper can't get elected. Yeah, he's a young whippersnapper, but he's a smart young whippersnapper. We need more smart young whippersnappers who get it. But the liberals want us to believe that this can't be done. But I love proving them wrong. Love proving them wrong. We can do this. And one of the questions that I always get, well, after you got out of the race, most people thought you were just going to go away, shut up, be quiet, not cause any trouble. Denise, they got me wrong, didn't they? They got me totally wrong. And so I'm still doing TV, gonna continue to do TV, might be doing more of it. Continue to do radio. January, we're going to be taking over a syndicated radio talk show. But I'm not going to wait till January before I start raising hell about what we need to do. We got to do something between now and November. And I already told you what that is, but I'm still going to continue to be a voice, because even after November, folks, we are still going to have to continue this movement. Because as former Senator Eric Dirksen said, when they feel the heat, they will see the light. And we've got to be that heat constantly through all of the various organizations that are out there. I don't care which organization you are a member of, your organization has got to get active and stop being timid in order for us to be able to put the heat on Congress. Even if we succeed at maintaining control of the House, getting control of the Senate, we still have to put heat on them to do the right things. Because too many of them get there and they become part of D.C. So we got to keep the heat on. And that's what's going to happen past November. But up until then, we have got to focus on that mission. Maintain control of the House, get control of the United States Senate, take back the White House, and begin to change the thinking in the State House in the state of Michigan. A lot of things motivate me. A lot of things inspire me, just like you. Everybody has a different switch to trick that trigger relative to what you do in order to help your community. And I tell people I could give you at least 9 reasons, but I'm not going to give you 9. I'm only going to give you 4 of the reasons that causes me to do some of the things that we are going to do. One of the things we're going to do between Steve Hantler, the Bernie Marcus organization, and my organization is that we are conducting in the fall something called a truth tour. Because of all of the lies out there on TV and in the media. The truth tour. And the truth tour is going to be 30-33. We're going to visit 30 cities in 30 days over a 60-day period and do 3 events a day. In the morning, we're going to be having meetings with local clergy and minority leaders, because the faith-based community will play a big part in what happens in November. Our noon luncheon event is going to be a luncheon of CEOs within the community, because CEOs have got to stop being timid in talking to their employees about the issues and the solutions and what they need to do. And then in the evening, late afternoon, we will be making a stop at 30 universities in primarily the battleground states. And Michigan is a battleground state. I believe that we already have scheduled for the Truth Tour, University of Michigan, Michigan State, and Central is what we're going to be doing. Why? Because the young people matter. They matter. And many of them want to be a part of the solution and not a part of the problem. So that's what we're going to be doing. People say, well, why are you doing all of that? I'm not doing it for fame or fortune. No. Let me give you four reasons as to why I do what I do and why they're not going to shut me up. I'm going to give you four reasons. Grandbaby number one. Grandbaby number two. Grandbaby number three. And grandbaby number four. Those are my four reasons. Because you see, folks, it's not about us. It's about the grandkids. It's about the kids and the grandkids, so it's not about us. I don't want to leave them mess that we have allowed to happen. You are here to support Brad because of the same reason. I'm not running. I'm just talking. But Brad is running. Dunn is running, and a lot of other people are running for office. They're making that sacrifice. And I challenge you, in this situation that we're in, to do all that you can do, whatever it is. Volunteer a little time, put some signs in your yard, knock on some doors, talk to family members and friends. Whenever I go to a reunion, it's like a Democratic convention. And I dare them to get into a debate with me. They always lose. Imagine that. They always lose. But the good news is the truth wins out every time if you know the truth, which is why we're doing the Truth Tour. So I want to thank Brad Hantler and his family for inviting me to be here with you today and giving me an opportunity to encourage you to support him so we can begin to change things at the local level, the state level, as well as the national level. Now let me leave you with this. When the founding fathers conceived two of the greatest documents in the history of the world, the greatest publication in the history of the world is the Holy Bible. Next to that, the Declaration of Independence. Next to that, the Constitution of the United States, and we will not tread on the Constitution of the United States of America. When the founding fathers conceived of those ideals, life, living in the pursuit of happiness, they were the founding fathers of this great nation. We must be the defending fathers and mothers of this great nation based upon those principles. And when you get to the part of life, living in the pursuit of happiness, I tell people all the time on my radio show, if you want to do something to change America, get to life, living in the pursuit of happiness, and keep reading. Don't stop at that point. Keep reading. Because if you keep reading, you will find that it says in that next paragraph, whenever those ideals are threatened, it is the right of the people to alter or abolish it. we've got some altering and abolishing to do, including altering the occupant of the White House and altering the state of Michigan by electing Brad Hantler, one of your state legislators. God bless you. God is blessing America.
Thank you, Herman. Folks, there's a little bit more to go. And that's 13. You know what 13 means? In exactly 13 days, we will know who wins this election. Here's your call to action. We need your help on election day.
All right, how'd you want?
This guy right here.
This
right
guy. 39th District.
Hi, I'm Ron Edwards, host of the Edwards Notebook radio commentary, syndicated on several stations around the country. We had a real great event here tonight with Herman Cain and Mr. Hantler, who's running for state legislature here in Michigan. We've got a great candidate. We've had a great time. Mr. Cain gave us a very inspirational speech and very encouraging for all of us. And Mr. Cain had a great speech this evening, and we know that we're going to have a great time this November when Mr. Hantler is elected into the Michigan State Legislature and when Mr. Obama is removed from the White House. No more White House occupier. We will have a new president, a real president, this coming January, and I'm looking forward to it. And again, I'm Ron Edwards, host of the syndicated Edwards Notebook Commentary.
John Hall, I'm running for Congress in the 14th District. I attended this evening Brad Hantler, awesome event, and Herman Cain, Mr. 999, knows how to bring a crowd together and actually make them want to go out and do something. And that's what we need every Republican to do, and independents, and Democrats, to understand this country is on the brink, and we need every person to get out this year and vote. Vote the right person, not the right party. Thank you. I'm John Haller, and I need your vote. Visit my website, hollerforcongress.com. I appreciate it. Please support the right candidate. Thank you, and God bless this great country.